Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the XRL GP2 Division for round number 13 or 14. I've lost count. I've lost count completely of the round number already, but we're here at Singapore for one of the toughest tracks of the season. And, well, I have got my mic fixed, which is a brilliant thing, so don't have to be on Skype, so yes. I've got my mic fixed, so yes.
It may have been the reason why I never so cool, but Andy's just hit the wall.
Fantastic. Andy's just hit the wall. Whack. Yes, we're joining you Singapore with me. Obviously, you know me and Wes are here by now. I'm also joined by Paul Marley. Hello, Paul. Oh.
Hello,
Marley.
Joe Upton.
Come on. Don't disgrace my name.
Upson.
Yes. Anyway, glossing over my name, we do have a dry qualifying session here in Singapore, but for the race, there's a 50% chance of rain, exactly half, which, I don't know, it makes things really interesting around Singapore, because it's a weird sort of track.
We're going to have a paddock, okay? First, good evening, Joe and Wes, hello.
Yeah,
he doesn't know you here, Paul, that's great. How are you? I'm good.
But, I'm
how are
good
you,
as well. I've got chicken, Gary, if you're wondering. I'm eating
you're
dinner.
You're very good, then. I hope no one does a me, apparently, again, and tries to take options 15 laps at the end of the race. By the way, I'm not doing that on Thursday, because Gary, he vowed that he would not mess up the strategy.
Well,
it's fine.
I need Gary to mess up badly, because I've got 20 chicken nuggets on the line.
Well, technically, he's only given you 6, you've only got 6.
And I'd give him 6, but... it's the fact I have to pay for it all still. No, it's not over expensive, but it's just a personal prize.
5 quid.
Some people are poor.
I am poor, but 5 quid.
No. Still.
I sound poor. Oh, Andy's hit the wall again.
Lost an end plate that time.
Yeah.
But yeah, well, yeah, Brandy in the wall twice there. We said this is one of the toughest tracks in the calendar as well. Mr. Steer has just got pole there. I know it's down by 3 thousandths of a second, but that's been obliterated by Big H. He's gone a 9/10 clearer.
There,
Mandy
Brandy
has gone to second, a tenth behind.
Yeah. Big Man Sean says Team McLaren for the win. Afternoon. So, at least it's my favourite track. At last. It's his favourite track. Says
one of my favourite tracks as well. I do love it.
The last season in TSX, I believe Patronus got a podium.
Oh, I don't know. Ooh, Mayo. You can search this up.
Connor K is on pole. He's in pole of 42. I don't know what times to expect from these lot round there. I reckon we can get to the 41.
John's cut that, sadly, hasn't he? So I'll just jump off him because that probably won't allow that. The game is mean to us all. I don't know what to expect from the UBO. They're at a nice time, I think. 41's possible easily. Yeah, I don't see why not.
So this is funny. Andy Friendly's sitting in third, but he's got the base of his front wing left. He's got his teammate just behind him. I don't know if he's on a lap, and I don't know if he'd let him through or not if he is on a lap.
No, I don't think he is. He's at 1 minute 30,
right? Yeah.
That's a no. Oh, that one, so in 7th. Hair is
in 8th. We will expect this to be the longest race time of all the 50% races we do. I'll probably pushing the hour mark. Doing a bit of a race yesterday
hour
in terrible conditions.
Hour 5, rain, isn't there? So yeah, hour 5, maybe an hour 10.
Yeah, safety car is a very
high
possibility here.
Yeah.
Especially
comes
with a curve.
He's got pole. 141.8. That's way down to pole. Way up.
Michael, well, no, he's got pace around this, so he'd be very happy with himself if he can maintain that. I probably sound like a really fat kid with his mouth stuff right now.
Yeah, you do.
I think Mr. Stable's DRS is broke. Is he reducing it?
Oh. That's not going to help, man. XRL probably comes up last team to the end now. There's a 1.32. Puts him 6th place. Oh, what the hell?
Oh, Samsler hits the wall.
Wow, that looked well weird on mine. On mine, he didn't hit the wall. He hit the curve and it pulled him into the wall. Okay, that didn't look normal.
Yeah, that happened to me last season in tier 6
when
I was behind Tommel.
That's very weird.
I tried to, you know, break early to flip the apex and then I hit the apex straight into the wall, so...
Mm. Yeah. That happens, then.
Yeah, the curves around this track, the curves really do throw you off, so...
Top to curve, XRL Patron is now fully answering the question of, did he get a podium? Well remembered button, yes. My first season I came 4th here my second race in XRL and last season I third. Yes, he did get a podium last season in Rouse Singapore, so well remembered. Very well. Very well remembered, brilliant. Brilliant from the pole. Podiums. Well, Michael is going to throw it into the pits. We have our first time trials, really. Hotshot and John Digweed not being able to set a lap so far. John cut on his lap, as from what I saw. The pair last of the people who have set a lap. It's the first time I think I've said that this season. Davey is not here because he's on the one.
Oh, dear me. Come on now.
I said boy great, so didn't want to attempt it.
I think he's going to be practicing for the new season.
He probably won't start in about 6 months. Judging by how...
By that point, I'll hopefully be doing... Yeah. But hopefully by that point, I'll be racing in real life, so screw this. That's the plan!
So, I'm guessing you're going for your racing licenses?
Oh, hell yeah,
driving licenses?
Oh, I'm going for
both. Oh, you're going for both, okay.
I'm going for both.
But if you have a racing license, you don't need a road license.
Yeah, but my mum's strict and it's first comes driving.
Oh, okay.
It seemed to be the rule for years. It's pretty weird.
Yeah. Well, stranger than that, they changed the rules in the FIA now, but Verstappen got a super license before a road license.
Yeah.
I find that funny.
Well, I thought you needed a road license before you got your super license.
Yeah, I thought you'd need something like that, but
yeah,
I know they're changing it now.
Where's Amali? Good evening, where's Amali? So I'm not poor after the 7th. I had chicken noodles and one fried egg for 2
Joe. Was that Gary by any chance?
That is Gary. He smiled after that. Go on, Shadowhunter. First at the moment, says Patronus. Not Shadowhunter anymore, but
it's
he's definitely
Captain Witter.
Back to that. Definitely Hunter. He's never sure what to call himself, really. All we knew is he's called Monkey. That's about it. That's really all about it. Still hasn't got his very first win. Technically got one, but he doesn't count it because he's done it and he has getting counted. Which is fair enough. He wants to win on the track.
Don't they? We nearly had the actually won.
Now, Michael technically won a race, but not in track because he got penalty. He doesn't count it, which is fair enough, not to count it, technically, yeah. So, he's still waiting for his first overall time.
Don't
take
goes fourth. 142.4.
He's still waiting for his first race win next year as well. It's incredible, it really is.
He's always good in qualifying, is John, and he normally chooses some really good strategies. I'm not sure why it's not paid off yet.
I don't have a clue. I really don't have a clue.
I think it's because he's really conservative. You know, he doesn't really attack too much. He'll only go for... He's basically like Jism. You know, he wouldn't really, you know, risk an overtake and lose his traction.
Alex Ham, going to do a 42.4, puts him 6th.
But, yeah... John Digweed reminds me a lot of Jism.
Jism, I can see that.
John's a really good qualifier though as well.
He's a really good pace as well, that's the thing. It really is John Digweed.
Yeah, I've been telling Jism to go for overtakes when you see it.
Bulk up, go on Jism.
Yeah, like, I just like, you know, you gotta attack if you
want to
make up.
Use the elbows. Good evening, Joe. Mate, game audio is really... We really can't hear you very well. Ah, that may be. My brother broke my microphone. Let me turn it up a little bit, though. I do blame him for that. For breaking it. And also, people...
Trips.
Also, I was on Skype. And people got annoyed. So I'll just turn it back up there. And now you can all stop complaining.
Aha!
I'm
enjoying this track. It's very flowing, doesn't matter. I'm liking the flowingness of the track. Yeah, don't worry, I understood that you meant that. But, yeah, Stevie Pear, gonna get himself in the top 10. Here we go, 142.7, puts him 7th.
Somebody you ever see Pear at the front.
Yeah,
Andy Franzi's broken into the 40s. I think that's gone a bit unnoticed, but he's done a 40.9.
That's gone very unnoticed.
He's gone almost 9/10 quicker than Michael, which, well, that's blisteringly quick.
This is Gary. This is a great message from Gary. I'm still waiting for my first win in XRL. Next week in Japan, I will break my duck in XRL. Break his duck. There you go. Patronus says that's
Gary,
better. Good.
I just wanna get
He's going to break his duck, ladies and gentlemen. He's going to break his duck. The quote of the century, Gary will break his duck in XRL.
Hashtag that. Hashtag it.
Hashtag Gary breaks
Hashtag
duck.
Hashtag break a duck.
Gary, you're cruel to ducks. Come on, there.
Well, I'm going to make sure you win Japan. Even though I'm really bad around Japan. I'm bad. I'm not very good at all. I almost think Gary could almost out-qualify me.
Gary's had a decent round
Japan. For some reason, Japan is...
I like Japan.
Somewhat like Singapore. But, you know, I really like Japan, but I don't like Singapore.
Say what?
Japan, I'm just not very quick around there.
I like Japan. I haven't hit the wall yet, and I've done 20 laps, as Matty, so he's happy. And no, he won't, says XRL Hamilton. That's towards Gary winning the race. Hamilton also fighting top from F5, as always. We will watch them on Thursday fight for the next win in Singapore.
Well, I can already predict the F5 podium for Japan.
Oh, for Japan? Crikey, okay. Go on, predict next week's podiums.
It's going to be...
Oh, that's close.
Either Hamilton or Mocha.
Hamilton? Hamilton or Mocha, then, so you're not really predicting too much here, are you?
Well,
Hamilton or Mocha, you're not going for a solid prediction yet.
Right, I'm going to predict Hamilton with it, Mocha second,
right.
And
right.
Then
Molly
third.
Going for Maddie, ooh. As I get a message from Maddie now, he can't hear what you said because it's about a minute delay, but Gary, Japan is one of my best tracks next Thursday. And wait there, I'll read that in a minute. No, I won't. Hotshot does not... I don't even know if he improved or not. Break my duck. I don't know how to take that, says Patronus. I don't even know how to take that either. Now my messages are going to be respam, so I won't be able to tell you whether there's any messages left. We've just got over 10 seconds left.
Oh, Michael's at the wall underneath the tunnel. He was on a blisteringly quick lap as well. I could tell by the times he was going to... I reckon he was going to challenge for pole, but that has ruined his qualifying. Not really, he's qualifying because he's still sitting in second, but has ruined any chance he's got of trying to challenge for pole, so he's second to best he's going to hope for.
Oh, so Samster got fourth.
Improvement.
Somewhere Samster nipped fourth. For the moment, anyway. STV Pairs nicked sixth. Go on him into the tunnel. See what he can do. Hopefully he doesn't.
Carl's going to lag out because he was lagging so much.
He's the host, so that's not good. He's the only one in green, but that's interesting.
Patch had movement starting to lag as well.
That's not good for them. Pear comes on the last two corners now. Is it going to be in the 40s? No. Is it going to be in the 41s? No. Pear doesn't improve. He stays sick. That's really shocking from Pear. Not bad at all, but still quite shocking that he's not up there. Everybody beating him today. And no Davey, so Davey decides not to race at the time where it seems Pear is struggling. So that's not really a good call. My message is all being spammed, which is absolutely fantastic. Fozzy, is he on a lap to go through the tunnel now? What do we reckon? Possibility. He's only got into the 30s now. Down to the last couple of corners. Into the last two now. How fast does he take it? Decently fast. He is on a wheel. Does he improve on himself? No. Stays just 11th.
Samster's hit the wall underneath the tunnel. That being a tourist corner to it. So he's not improved. Upshot's coming into the pits as well. So.
And
there's
Steve-O's
another
not.
Driver on a lap. Which, well, Mr. Steve-O is not on a lap. That's
that's all done then.
Time. No, I think half of the grid have had a load of lag specs from what I've seen.
So track position being crucial, especially with that chance of rain, which could upset the start of the race. And, well, judging by the weather patterns around there, it's probably likely to start wet. and dry up. So, and if Randy is in that prime position, get Popper nearly a second. He was 0.882 clear of.
That's the biggest, that is a massive margin. That's going to be good for his confidence. Biggest gap we've seen in GP2 this season, I think.
It's Danny Brandon really coming opened. On form in the last few races. One in Monza, and he is carrying that form over to here. Big H. Got to qualify for him to get third, only a tenth beyond Michael, so. And looking out to go in front of Royce Amster, surprisingly up into fourth. A lot of big names struggling down there. Perry, as you say, in sixth. Obviously, you'd expect him to see him further up in ninth. Alex Hammond, eighth, so. You know, a lot of really good and quick drivers seeming to struggle on the streets of Singapore. It's a very tough track to master, and when you do, it is good, as Andy Ferranti has found out. But a lot of drivers seem to struggle, which could pave the way for a very unusual podium if things do come to plan, of course. We've got a rain chance, which could spice it up even more.
Jack Picker says, hashtag Team McLaren.
Joseph? I'm here, I'm speaking. the option tires are starting.
I got confused whether you were doing it on purpose, and when you said Joseph, I was like, wait, can you just not hear him or something?
Yeah, because I was responding.
Yeah, he was responding. I got very confused there. All I heard from my right ear was, Joe! Paul, Joe, Paul, Joseph, I am here. I was like, okay, right. Having a weird conversation with each other there.
Shall we do our predictions before we go into a game show?
Yeah, I've not done predictions in a while. I always like to predict a podium.
So I'm liking this.
Let me get my notepad and I can write predictions down anyway. Yeah. If you lot want to send your predictions, and we'll do it for the podium, not just for the race win.
Yeah. Patronus says, did Joe say 50% chance of rain? Here comes safety car. I think we've had 11 safety cars this season. Sam's still 7 times up when he crashed.
As your ear.
Go on.
I sound like it's Sam. As your ear, Paul, I'll let you predict first.
Is this for podium or for
podium?
The podium, yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Podium.
Last season, just from Michael's pick alone, I'm going to say he's going to win it.
Ooh.
Then.
Wait, who's going to win it?
Michael.
Oh.
Then STB, STB Power, and then. Okay.
Well, then let you go second.
I'm not, because I'm going to say Bitters. Big Man Sean has sent in his. He says BH. Hey, Captain Wader. Second, Big H. And third, Andy for Andy.
Well, I'm going to go. I'm going to be a little bit boring and go Andy for the win. I'm going to go for John to get second. I'm going to get second. And Alex Ham to third. I'm going to really push the boat out here because of the changeable conditions. You know what Alex is like?
Good point. Matty says, how many front wings will be lost tonight? It's a good question. XRL Patronus says, Michael's first, second BH, and he can't think of third place.
But let me write this down.
Did you write down Sean?
Big H second.
Yeah, Big H second.
Sean's.
Yeah, well, did you write down Sean's?
No.
Captain, it was Michael, Big H, and Andy.
Michael. A lot of people get Michael for the win.
Yeah.
So yours was Andy, John, and Alex then? Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well.
Mine will be Andy. And.
Almost.
Andy. Big H.
Bigger.
And Michael.
Okay, so I'm the only one who's really gone for sort of different. I'm not probably gone for a bit of a different podium as well.
Well, if we said this last week, it would be different as well, to be fair.
Well, I've gone for different podiums, different drivers. I think we should speak to drivers ahead of this race, see how they are feeling.
Yeah.
Fast. Well, it's the toughest race on the season, I will say that. The toughest race.
Probably.
It is.
They have steering assist on.
Hi guys.
Hey Joe.
Oh, we got another one.
No swearing, please.
Joe, we got another one.
Please tell me that Andy Ferrari has a reprimand at least.
No.
No. Nope.
I'm still questioning right. How.
To be honest, even I said the time went under the radar, but we just weren't watching.
We just weren't watching him.
Yeah, we weren't expecting that. Because earlier in the session we just see Andy hitting a few walls, like just hitting the same wall over and over, and then we see that time pop. Where the hell was that come from?
The first lap I was just wall banging like a god. Yeah. I lost both end plates.
Yeah, I saw that, Andy.
did you see my initial pop?
I did.
Was on an out lap.
Well, yours was more noticeable, but we
Michael, I think I did, but for part of it, I may have been reading out a message at one point, but I did see most of it, I believe.
So, Michael, you've been unpredicted to win by quite a few people.
And
so,
another person, Matty says Michael first, Andy second, and Pear third.
Michael's the win, dude, there
is. Wait, what?
He doesn't know it's
like
a win.
Tell me where.
Michael, Andy, Pear.
Andy, Pear, right. I've gone for this, well, judging by the group position, it's the strangest podium.
Wait, and actually, another one. So Patronus is third, is Samster.
Who said that?
Patronus's third place is Samster, because he had question marks in there, so
it's... Samster, yeah.
Oh, Gary's being nice to you. Gary's being
range.
Nice to Michael.
I thought
Gary...
I the equation.
Stop going for me!
Gary
Stop
says
it.
Michael to crash, Pear to win.
Oh,
so I'm a bit of a change there. Another Take one now. Another one, Moon Tricks.
Yeah,
no, that's just his. I have another podium here though.
Oh god.
Moon Tricks says Andy first, second Michael, third Pear. So there you go.
I kind of see me going forward, like.
Andy first, Michael second, and third Pear, and that was Moon Tricks.
Joe, do you want to tell them your prediction?
We'll tell them. You know us, right? Paul's gone for you, Michael, to win. Gone for Pear for second, and Connor for third.
No pressure.
I've done really good logic here. You'll like this. Want Andy to win. A bit boring. Gone for John for second. And I've gone for Alex for third.
Woo!
Wait
for that rain.
Yeah. See.
Yeah. He's like logic.
I like this one from Samster. Wait, I like this one from Samster. He says, first rain, second safety car, third Sam in the wall. I'm liking that one. I'm liking that.
The reason why I went for you, Michael, is because of last season's performance.
I didn't even win!
Oh, but you were very quick.
I got the podium.
XRL Patronus
Michael,
says no pressure.
People think you're gonna win. Take it as a compliment.
Yeah, yeah. By the way, Patronus says no pressure, Michaels. It's fine. No pressure. No pressure at all, Michael.
Right. I've not got any more space for podiums, by the way. Like, I've got to have my notepad for incidences and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah. What about? You didn't even say who I picked. I can't even remember who I picked.
Wes picked Andy to win, Big H for second, and Michael for third. There you go.
I'm gonna get the podium, Jesus.
I think
I don't think we're gonna finish. Does that make you feel better, Michael?
During the race, can you find out what time I got last season? If you have it.
I don't think I have it.
Or if you remember.
I got four,
but I got pole, but I wanna know whether I beat my time from last season.
I have no idea, because I don't think they were updated at that point, so... The only way to find out is go to my video if I did one for Singapore. Did I do one for
you?
No,
the Singapore times are updated.
Yeah, you
do.
Know,
they're
on the
time.
Are they on? They're on
now. Are they actually real?
Yeah.
So what time did you do then?
F1, the poll was a 40 point something.
No, it was a 49 something because it was Inter.
Oh, no, yeah,
GP2
was a 40 something.
The Forza Hungarian race was good, mate. BH to come second and third Andy says Gary. I have no clue who he... I don't have a clue who he thinks is going to win.
Yeah, he put Air to win.
Did he? Oh, XRL Hamilton says Fozzie to win.
Thought Hamilton would be on my side.
Michael, you got in the 41s last season, as I remember, because me, Adam, and somebody else were streaming it.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I got a 41, but it was a 41 what?
I think it was a low 41, I think. It was a 41.2 or 41.3.
Progress.
Dark
forces at the back.
Yeah,
so I went slower.
Yeah. So yeah, the beginning of the season,
I went 8 seconds slower than last season.
But that was rain.
I mean, full wets instead of intermediates, but.
We get this in the way. Let's see.
What are we? Oh yeah. Are we ready, everybody?
Yes.
Are you? Safe. Are you sure?
Right, I'm gonna be my guys.
He's got to concentrate. Right. He has to concentrate. He's going for the win. Over five people think he's going to win. Is Michael going
to
win? Over five people believe in him.
I think we having our traditional first corner race?
No. Not today.
No, it's a very short run down to turn one here, so it's best to probably just retire and jump on the action. So
no one saw it last week.
See what tyres people go on. To start this race.
Theorem have put me on grounds.
No, really?
Yeah. And also as well, because it's a nighttime race, you can't particularly see it held over as much.
Oh, wait, so they put me on options, so.
You've got to wait for the engineers to sort of tell you, and you've got to wait for the rain to come. You can't base it on cloud cover or anything like that. As to when the rain will come, but I don't think they'll bother drivers too much, they'll just be driving around as quick as they can. A lot of drivers sticking to the option higher.
I feel like I think all of them did. I don't see anyone on prime from here.
No, it's probably the smartest way to go. Options are quite a bit quicker than the primes around here. Not much difference in the tyre wear, but that will be a factor as we are away here at Singapore.
Ow, I think I got hit as I retired.
And if Randy has made a good start, he's defending his line to turn. He has cut that completely and run off the
cut
road.
Both.
He cut, but that was shocking there by Andy. But he's maintained his first, nobody was challenging him anyway, so he penalised. There's a bit of squeezing at the back, but it should be fine. Michael's made a good start, but he's made a mistake over the curve of turn numbers. There's a lot of turn numbers. Just that corner there.
I think it was four.
And that is allowing the Sauber off Big H to close up on him, but he can't quite do it. A lot of drivers, are they going to get their braking spot on? Yes, there's not
looking
really
quite good.
Been any. Calamity's further back to Samford's maintaining that fourth place for now. But in the case, well, he dropped down a little bit into fifth. I think he started fifth actually, so he's not actually.
Everybody's clean.
Big John Digweed is up into sixth place, so he's made a decent.
Oh, there's a Mercedes passing the Lotus.
Seventh.
That was a good move by whoever the Mercedes is there. Past that Lotus
that
right there, that was
really
good.
Will be hot shot Moomin, he's got himself up to 8th place past the Lotus of STV Pair, I believe that'll
Great.
Be. He's dropped down 3 positions, he's really struggling around this track. Which is very odd to see, normally one of the quickest drivers, if not the quickest in this division, struggling on the streets here. Bevo sitting in 10th, and the other Williams of Fozzie is in 11th. But the start, not really being any major winners in terms of positions game, but definitely Pair being the biggest loser out of all of this. Everyone's pretty much line and stern except from the three which have overtaken Pair. They're 7th, 8th, 9th, now 6th, 7th, 8th. So Andy Brandy with around a second lead ahead of Michael.
Joe, I think your mic went.
Your mic went?
Yeah, you go. Unplug it back in.
And
then there's a... He went, like that. Joe?
All blessed with that. Oh, Andy's had a lag spike.
Alex hit the
ball. Andy's had a lag spike. Michael leads the race, which is not something I've said a lot.
Alex
is Andy
going
to get
out
first place? No, he's lost first place to Samster. But that lag spike costing Andy 3 places, crucial early on in this race. Track position is vital around it, and he's lost it. For the two Salvers, and Michael is going to try and streak away from the field. What an opportunity is this for him to get his first proper win. He says he's had one win in the past because of penalties, but he'd like to do this one on the track if he can.
He doesn't count it in all of his head.
I'm going to eat more of my food, so commentate.
Right behind Alex Harm after his leg strike.
That's Alex, Andy. Alex is further behind trying to pass to William, he's not going to get it done though.
I believe Andy's in the rib, or Alex is in the rib as well.
Yeah, they're both right, yeah, Alex is two cars behind him, that's squeezing by Salva and the Red Bull, fighting for third.
Where's the Mercedes?
No, we've lost that, Sam is the host. No, you've lost
we've
me.
We've lost John Digweed and Big H and Marley.
Me.
Oh, we didn't cover that.
Oh.
Oh, no, we actually lost then. Because now they're fighting for third here, so... We must have lost Samsa as well. I think we lost Samsa as well, so we've lost... Yes, we have. We lost you, Paul, Big H, John Digweed, and XRL Fozzy.
That's going to have to be a restart then, isn't it? That's a massive
so we lost 1, 2, 3. We lost technically 3 drivers.
Eight drivers left.
Well, did you lose Alex Ham as well?
No.
3 drivers enough, isn't it?
We lost 3. Well, it's not even half. And that's squeezing between the Lotus and the Red Bull and the Ferrari. Well, Konica versus Andy for third now, that is.
What are we going to do then?
We lost 3, which is only...
That's enough
not under half.
Two laps, isn't it?
I don't think so. Then you need to lose half the grid.
I'm very sure it's 3 drivers by a certain distance.
No,
I don't think it
half
is.
The grid within the first stint.
Well, we had 11 drivers, so if we lose 2 more...
Yeah.
And that's...
That's good enough.
We lost us 2 as well. Well,
yeah, you don't count
as
drivers. So you said he lost, we lost that. So you went, we lost connection to Alex. I sat like, oh yeah. And then everyone, like, you got.
Yeah,
clear.
I knew as soon as that happened, pretty much, and didn't see migrating host. Well, that's very strange, and, well, Michael's leading this race then
by a quite
a comfortable margin, actually, ahead of second place Samston there. I'm confused at this grid order, so only ran is in third, but he's not really catching up. Honor's in 4. I don't know.
We lost Big H, Hotch, I think, what was it? Big H, Fozzy, and John Digweed.
Alright, okay. I don't know. I'm confused.
Strange, you normally have it and don't normally have that.
But then if anybody's prediction's gonna be right anymore.
No,
because I've lost Big H and you've lost John.
Oh, my driver is still on?
Yeah, they are, I think.
Yep. That pair is in it and he is.
Oh, lag spike for Connor K.
Oh,
that's not helped him.
No.
A small lag spike, but still not going to help.
He's still got the gap to, I believe that's Alex. Is that Alex?
Yes, it is. And then hot shot, then pair behind.
But it said Alex Ham lost connection, and then...
No,
yeah,
you lost connection
to
him. You lost connection, you guys lost connection to him.
Oh, yeah, that's the massive disconnection off his host.
Well.
Which is very unfortunate.
He hasn't got the best connection there.
But yeah, everyone else is great, and they normally are, so normally it's fine. Normally it's
absolutely fine. Our connection, which we're in his.
Something's not right there. I think I hadn't had any lag up, still haven't had any lag break, so that was weird. Hot shot behind Alex. It's not helping Pear right now, is it?
No, not really.
I think he's really...
3 places, but, you know.
Yeah, go for it. Well, I think he was ahead of Fozzy, so he's really getting too early. Okay, points, but still gaining. Even more lead. Five out of 31. Everyone says this is a long race, but first 5 laps for me have gone decently quick, to be fair to them.
I've not been here for one of them.
You didn't miss one lap. You didn't even miss one lap.
I did, so disconnected like sort of the end of lap two, and then Mark was just starting lap four.
It weren't lap.
No, I can't remember.
No, you didn't miss the lap that lap, gosh. It did not take you 1 minute 40 or something to get back in. And then it took you about 23 a minute.
23 corners around this track.
There's a lot of opportunity to corner cut them.
Oh, Mego must have had a lag spike because he's falling back a bit.
Yeah, Samster's well within reach of him now. Well, not well within reach, but he's closer.
Yeah.
It's either a mistake or... But let's check if he's got any front wing damage, because that is... No, he hasn't.
Let's see, he hit the curb and he lost traction.
That can happen. Curbs are notoriously bad round here.
Kind of like, the curves at Monza.
Samster's at the wall there quite hard. I don't believe he's actually sustained any damage. I don't know how that sold, but a bit tough. That's strange. The Lan Andy friend is catch right back up.
Okay, just running quite quietly and forth.
Oh no, side pod! Half side pod with Alex Hammond. Hot shot. Pair takes sixth. No damage done, but I think they just got a bit too close together and touching it. Well, they touched the slightest amount. It's half spun hot shot.
Probably lost about 6 tenths. SAB power, but it's up.
Yeah, about that. Didn't happen too much for Savage, his pair was that close, and then he nicked the place. But yeah, that was interesting, that one. We could write that down for review, if we need to.
Well,
I think we might as well. Lap 6.
Something.
After the bridge.
I'm just gonna write bridge.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. About 14. Around about 10, 14 it is, I think. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, yeah. About 14.
That's right after the bridge.
Hot shot, and Alex had a little bit of touch, but a half cycle.
Do you
mention
hot shot?
No. Well, no, do you mean do I have to watch him?
Yeah.
No, apparently you do.
Okay, so I wrote down a wrong name.
Now, everyone which I said for you to watch, I wrote down a cross next to their name. So don't have to watch them. Smart thinking.
Just a waste of paper then?
Oh, look at the Red Bull. Randy Friendly on the outside of Sam's today thought about it, but... realised there was no room on the outside. Samster's
oh,
lost an end plate, so...
Michael scraped!
On level oh, Samster's at the wall again, and yeah. So Andy Friendly also lost an end plate, so the battle of the wounded here for second place. Samster and Andy Friendly are both staying out, so Michael's going to get a massive undercut on these two, unless he comes out of trap, which he wants to.
Pairs in, pair and hot shot in.
Well, there is a chance of rain, so maybe they're going to try and preempt that.
Options for Michael.
Mr. Steve goes up to Beth.
Quite a long pit lane here, it's about 20, 23, isn't it?
Probably the longest pit time loss here. It's about 20, I'd say he lives about 25 seconds around here. Because of the pit lane limiter.
Yeah,
as the Red Bull of Andy Fred is on the inside of Samster for the lead of this race. Samster holding it around the outside, having to defend. This Red Bull is proving to be quick, and he's going for
the car. He's been dragged into the wall.
The wall dragged him in. The wall glitch, that is so unfortunate.
Blimey.
Oh, that's going to frustrate him.
Yeah, real frustrating. Connor Kay's going to sneak up the third and close in on him, isn't he?
Connor Kay is looking decent here.
He's quite a clean and consistent driver, and he's stuck as well, so...
Well, being consistent around here is key, especially with the high chance of losing bits of your front wing, and he's still got all his intact.
Can't wait for the rain to come and restart too, Matty. And still free in a lot at one point. Yeah, it's unclear. Apparently it's turn 15 to Gary. I don't see how that's turn 15. That's turn 1, that's turn 2, that's turn 3. That's 4, that's 5, that's 6. That's 7, that's 8, that's 9, that's 10, that's 11, that's 12, 13, that's 14. I don't see the... I don't see turn 15. I really don't. I don't see 15 corners in that time.
Turn 15.
Can he?
Honestly, I turned 16 though, that's a bit like
how?
16.
Just we count the straight as a blimmin' corner, aren't we?
I'm counting some of the little kinks.
I'm counting the kinks. Oh well, it's 14/15 or whatever the fuck
is. Mr. Stable, got a pit glitch. Put on a fresh set of options and a new front wing.
I think, oh no. Sam went out the white line, out the pit exit.
Mr. Steve has lost a lot of time.
Sam missed, you know, out the pit exit, went across the white line.
It didn't
gain him time, but of course he did it. He went out and then turned straight back into it. Yeah. I think that's because he's on a wheel, he couldn't turn it. Couldn't turn around it.
Mr. Steve done the exact same.
Or on the same lap.
Well, did he go across the white line and then turn straight back into it? Or they couldn't
actually... he crossed it, went out and turned into the corner.
Half the car
came across.
Samster went over the white line and then he turned straight back into the white line. He may not have been out there due to blimmin' thing. There's no input. The wheel has so... It's going to have better turning abilities, but it doesn't actually seem to help at all.
Because if you turn too quick, you're going to drop the traction of the car. Because I tried to practice on a wheel before, and I just kept losing traction when I turned in too quick.
There's on the back of Sam.
Hey, Pear made a decent undercut on these two in front of him.
And
he's 42.9. I don't know if that's the fastest lap or not, but it is proven to be very quick pace on a new set of options.
Last lap.
So the first person, I believe, to break into the 42s this race. And it might... stand as fast as lap if this rain comes anytime soon. I'm still not sure when it's going to come, but it should come around halfway through the race.
Connor Kay's going to get passed by Sam. A little bit of contact. He came out of the way, then back through. Pear's going to go through as well.
Pear through.
No, he's trying not to.
He's going to run around the outside. Ooh, that was
nice. Nice.
Nicely done. So he's recovered that mistake very, very luckily done as well.
Not to let the other driver through, you don't want to do that. That's not going to help at all for yourself, is it?
Not
another car
all.
Through. Even though you can't pass it, it's still a street track. At the end of it, you don't want to be stuck behind that car. You never want to be stuck behind another car, to be fair. We're on lap 10 out of 31.
First pit stops really quick and it's like Belgium or something. I don't want to be stuck. Taking with them.
You wouldn't like to be stuck through the second sector. First sector, you're car.
You wouldn't want to be stuck under the bridge.
I don't want to go up the roof side by side.
Well, I think they believe Ricardo went up it side by side when we were choosing who's going to lead the race.
Yeah, you can do it. When there's a driver that suddenly appears on the inside wing, isn't there? You don't want to do that.
Either the driver that just appeared backs off, or you back off.
No one likes to back off really, does everyone wants to put the foot down and go for it, especially up a roof, it's so easy just to go through. In these cars, anyway. Generally, would come down to is if you have to break into some cars.
Yeah, and the Mon cars, you would.
I think they have pretty good air right now, but I wouldn't be happy with that.
Yeah, but they don't have the biggest downforces from the Mon cars, though.
There is really not making any inroads into the car in front of Soundstage. Not really. In fact, he's dropping back a little bit from what I can see. So, you know, it's still strange to see a driver caliber pair struggling to catch up to other drivers because you, on most of the tracks, you'd expect him to be
right.
And he's struggling, and he's struggling. He has hit the wall quite hard, and he's lost. Well, he's down to the base of his front wing, and he's, well, he's understeering quite badly now for his last sector.
Sam's, oh my god,
he got on the curb. He got on that auto-spin curb. And, well, that's his front wing gone.
His front wing's gone.
And the pits now. That is desperately unlucky. Oh, he's hit the pit lane wall.
Pit lane wall.
And he understeering the pit lane wall. Is that going to bring out a safety car? We said there's a high chance of it.
I jumped off that as he turned in.
In the meantime, Hotshot and FTB Power are going side by side.
Yeah, it's true. You probably get a message from Sam saying, oops, or sadly, or whatever.
Oh, annoyed. Well, Michael's lost a bit of his front wing in first, and Andy's got his full front wing, so he's going to be catching up in this stint.
Hotshot runs against the wall before that corner.
That was interesting. Oh no, he did a mate. Don't want to do that on that curve. It's annoying.
The Lotus looks stupid with, like, no end plates.
Yeah, that was unfortunate for Sam.
I can't show, I can just tell it into the corners a lot
I
more.
I went off him as he turned into the bloomin'. He did the first part of the pit lane, and then I was like, okay. And then I jumped off him.
I believe Mocha said he can go faster around here with no end plates.
He didn't.
No, he can't. Sam says my... You're going to have to make the move soon. You might try and do a brave move. It's worth being on board.
Sam says my luck. And then a straight face. Not happy, Sam. He'll be racing against my... But it's called hitting the wall glitch. It's called hitting the wall, says Jonas. Not when you slightly tap it and it decides to be a magnet, it's not.
It's, hitting the wall of your talent.
The wall drags you in. Andy is on the back of Michael, by the way.
Yeah, I did mention Michael with that from damage.
Hot shot's got under steer. Wow, that was weird.
Completely misses breaking
zone there. So we're actually down to 7 now.
Andy's catching up to Hot Shot here, who in turn will be catching
up. Andy's catching
up.
Andy for Andy, did you just say?
Alex.
Yeah, you said the wrong word.
It's raining! Rain! There is rain here in Singapore, I've seen it. It's definitely not an illusion this time.
I think Sam will be a bit happy at the same time as annoyed that he's not here for the rain.
So, all these driving option tyres, they're going to be dying out soon. And are they going to try and brave it out there? Did anybody go on primes in this stint?
No.
And everyone with option, which is a little bit strange. You would expect some drivers to do things differently and try and... Anyone who's went on primes could have really made a big gain in this thing, because the rain... It depends how it falls.
Andy is all over Michael.
Normally when you see the rain coming, like, you would go option, option, option.
Yeah.
But,
some drivers like to do it different. I would have probably gone option prime around there.
Yeah, I would sometimes go primes, you know, just to go and ask a few laps in the rain.
If the pit lane loss is so big, I would go on primes, definitely. I'd try and do it less, one less stop. As Alex Am is at the wall.
You were going to say Andy.
Pitting. He's going to try and go for an undercut. He believes his tyres won't last until this rain becomes effective enough for intermediates. If it ever gets to that stage, that is.
He's going back on the prime.
Prime?
Or option, sorry. Option.
Okay, that's a very...
That's a good call, actually.
Well,
yeah, it is, yeah.
The rain is starting already, and there's no point going on fresh options. You may as well...
Yeah, there is.
It's
not affecting me.
Yeah, there
is,
because these tyres could fall off the cliff massively, and if there's a track I don't want dead tyres on, it's this one.
Yeah, he's doing the right call there, I think, because the rain's not affecting them yet by any means. This there is, they're tired, they're waiting. And by the way, if they've done 7 laps already and they're... Especially Michael, he did 7 laps in the first, and he's done 7 laps now. You know, he's going to be struggling bad.
And plus as well, these drivers, they'll try and pit for inters as quick as they can. They may get the call wrong, so Upshot's got a lot more flexibility back then when he can change.
And he is all over the back of Michael to the outside of Michael. I believe this is turn 14. They got very close to contact, but they're all fine. Very bad.
They try and hit in this lap and go for another set of options, because this rain isn't falling hard at all.
They are taking completely different lines to each other. The only line they're taking similar is through the tunnel, because really there's only one line through there. One attacking the curve more, one deciding not to use the curve. They both stay out for another lap.
Well, that's my corner coach, excellent.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
I've still got two more drivers.
Probably one of his lagged out. At least GP2, GP3 will be good tomorrow, so Sam, that's how you're looking forward to tomorrow.
Can I message you a driver to watch then?
Yeah, go ahead.
So you're not going to watch them right now in these conditions, are you? With dead tires and about the inters.
Well,
Andy goes to the inside of Michael, trying to go up the inside for the first place. He's got 8 brakes it and he's through easily. Andy takes the lead. A little bit of sliding tyres I heard in the background as well. And Andy made the capital will be fine. He's fine. He's in the lead of the race.
Looks like Hutchup movement's options is giving away traction. Is the track starting to get a bit wet now?
Connor Kay is somehow sitting there in third.
I'm saying merciful, but it's just not sending. This is really frustrating me.
Yeah, it's not happening to me yesterday. Like,
good to see.
Lags the message.
Yeah, good to see the Xbox servers are fantastic as always.
Couldn't complete this process. Please
see, there you go.
Again.
That might be another reason why people lagged out, possibly. Xbox
servers. You know what? I can't be bothered to send you a message on that. Where's my phone? I'm doing it on Facebook.
That would be easy. That rain is now. And he slides, so. The rain is nearly there.
People could be sliding because of the dead option tyres, don't forget that could
be. Oh, I know that. I'm waiting for spray. Well. I'm waiting for spray to say it's time. It's not time yet, but they are starting to have a bit of problem with only their tyre wear, but the rain may be affecting them completely. They're both pit. Michael pits because he was mirroring Andy.
What tyres are they going to put on? That is critical.
Connor stays out.
Connor stays out.
That was inters. That was inters for Andy. That must have been. It went green. It was his inters.
Out.
Inters for the both of them. Inters for Andy, inters for Michael.
Hairs come in as well. I believe this will be an intermediate stop for the Lotus. I don't believe the track is quite ready, but they might know it better than we do.
They're going in for
pair with a front wing change. Connor is leading this race now on his option tyres. They're not going to be in the best of shape, but they're slick at the end of the day.
You can easily. The problem is, you can easily see the tyre marks, which normally doesn't mean it's inters if you can see the tyre marks.
There's a little bit of spray though.
There is.
Oh,
no, trust me.
Right.
There will always be spray from inters. That's just how they're done. just give out spray, because that's quite nice. And he ain't got a bad gun, though. So they may have got it right.
Okay for him at the moment.
Yeah, yeah, they're not, he's not struggling, is he? They may have got that right. As he misses one apex, but that's probably why he's going to grab them all.
And if Randy Muslock has made the cooler, of course he didn't have to change his front wing, and Michael did, so that will set him back a few seconds.
Lose your front wing around here, it's like losing it at Monaco.
There you go, Paul.
Thank you. Oh, okay.
Sound now gone. Bit of understeer there, man. He's caught up on the Ferrari in front of him, believe Mr. Stevo, so he's obviously not struggling. And then they're pulled correctly. Very well done to him, Michael.
And Michael and Pierre,
yeah. It is,
we can see the full wet tyre before the end of this race.
The rain's coming down a little bit hard now, so yeah, there's one.
Come down about lap 20.
Yeah, and he's going to try and sneak past, but Mr. Stevo, he does. They're all in the pits now. They know, so Andy, fantastic team, Michael followed him in, fantastic ball by him and Pear as well.
Dotshot's gamble of being on them, it didn't pay off in the end, the rain did come down hard enough, Michael was going to slot back into second place, only just though, on the Ferrari.
Sorry, my screen may have just jipped because I didn't touch the screen long enough. So yeah, they have managed to make the correct call there. Pear goes ahead of Alex, I believe there. And everybody is in, Mr. Stevo's in. And Hotshot, of course, it didn't work out for him going back on those options. We thought it was a good call, but it's not now. This is going to call the rest of the conditions right if they change the full whips. Now Andy taps the wall.
Or if he even drives back up, which I don't believe would happen.
I doubt it.
Just steered into the wall there. He's not lost any damage. He gained damage. That's not good.
Oh, I've pressed the wrong button to go forward. I went instead of backwards. You go backwards. Pear and Alec are going to be fighting for fourth place. Oh god, Pear slides through that corner. Couldn't get anything there. Wow, so that's interesting. Alex is all over the back of him. We know he's good with, and we know he's good in changeable conditions and wet conditions. He was all over the championship leader for fourth. Do I have any messages? No, apparently not. Beat him. That nice spray there. Pear struggling, the championship leader struggling in intermediate conditions, and the guy that loves changeable conditions, Mr. Strategy, is there in fifth, all over the back of him right now, but they're going to go into the tunnel, which you can make moves from. I've done it before, but it's really difficult. Not close
Risky
enough to do anything.
Twirl.
I went round the outside of somebody into it. There was a bit of contact, but no damage. I count it as a good move. Damn it, done. Pear's pitting. What the hell?
Tires.
I'm struggling bad. Do you reckon he's gone for four wets?
That's a bit of a strange talk. The spray isn't enough by what it looks like.
He has.
He's gone for wets, so I very big gamble there. I reckon it's worth staying on him.
And now his car looks nice and blue. The car's like illuminated blue now, which does look pretty cool.
That's very strange. People on intermediate aren't doing overly bad.
You're not. It's Nathan Pitt. He's sliding. There you go. That's not in four words. Championship leader has just made the wrong call.
But
when the heck have we seen
that? Great as it was, so it may be worth the gamble on his part, but it is definitely not paid
it's not
off
worth
at least
it. It's
for
not,
now.
Yeah.
And if the rain comes hard enough in the next lap or two, then he's going to be losing a pit stop anyway. Plus, while then four wets, he's going to be sliding over. He's going to be overeating, which seems strange in these conditions. So they're going to be wearing out and, well,
they're
going to spend four wets and just stay on them, as Michael does the best corner cut I've ever seen. Yeah, I'd weave if I was you as well. Yeah, his tyres are not going to be in good shape. That's another great corner cut as well, Michael. done a lot of weaving? I didn't weave then. Oh, Michael. Damn. You know who I'm watching?
I'm watching Cash struggle. He's trying. Can't get the traction down out of that hairpin for anything, but he's trying to stay on the wet stuff. Not on the dry-ish line. No, he's trying to avoid that. It's not working. It's a really different call from Pear. One call I didn't expect to see. Past the halfway point a while ago. And only, oh god, he nearly may have had to go in neutral or something there to reward that wall.
And reverse. I know a few times in practice races I had to go into reverse to avoid walls around here. Strange technique, but it works.
It does work.
Wet Paris, lap 21, boys.
Whoa, the rain is coming down hard, and the spray is...
Yeah, I can see that.
I can see that happening.
I'm looking up the left and the right side, and looking at the place around, but yeah, I can see that. Yeah, no, I don't see why not. A couple of laps, two laps around here is quite a while, so yeah.
Andy for Andy struggling for traction into some of these corners there.
Yeah, Michael's doing the same thing. Well, they pit this lap actually, because I wouldn't blame any of them for trying it.
Would you blame them, wouldn't you?
Yeah, because it'll be risky to stay out and,
No, I wouldn't try it this lap, maybe next lap.
Oh, well, if they try it this lap, and they're coming in. They are coming in this lap. But the top two have come in, I mean, followed from behind.
Yeah.
Yes, they are. So the top three all in the box.
Pear hasn't done a decent job. They are struggling on the inters. Yeah, yeah, okay. They're all going.
Steve-O is coming in.
Yeah, they're all going for wets.
Moving. Well, Pear is.
They are struggling for traction. So, yeah.
But as well, his tyres are not going to be in the best of shape after coming in way too early, so not sure soon as well. So all the drivers will be on full wets now. And well, this is really now going to be survival of the fittest. The toughest conditions run, probably the toughest track of the season. If the conditions set up these full wets will last to the end pretty easily. You're going to have no tyre wear concerns. And if Randy with... Ooh, I'd say about a 5 second lead over Michael in second place. Getting a pole position and losing it at the start because of the lag spike, and he's come back through the field. Done a good job for Xander, and he'll be happy with himself at the moment if he can keep on the road for the next 11 racing laps, including this one. He'll be a very happy person. There's 12 racing laps here, so what am I about?
But Pear did get back out ahead of the hot shot.
But it's lost in time. Interesting to see what times these lot can do on whether anybody's going to catch up to other people.
Finished my dinner.
I finished my dinner about 10 laps ago. Michael's at the wall! Michael's at the wall and it's stopped him dead. And he's lost his front wing. Michael has lost it all. He's understeering. Connor's going to go into second place.
Holy cow.
Michael with a critical mistake under the tunnel. And coming in now, another set of bullets will be added, a new front wing will be added, but that has ruined any chance he's got of the race win. And the only person, I think, who didn't have Michael's podium, oh no, Gary didn't either, but he had Pear to win. So, that has ruined Michael's chance, so that promotes that. I've got the most realistic podium here. I'm sorry, but if John didn't lag out, he could have got second. I'm throwing that one out there now. So Andy Ferrandi has now got a healthy lead.
Has beaten Michael out.
Over Conoco.
Has ahead of Michael.
And Alex has got an even bigger gap in third to the car behind them, so the top three quite spread out. Don't expect any major change unless you see an incident like Michael did. That is so unfortunate. Especially seems as he was looking good to it. If he had the pace and the thought, he could have challenged for the win, and that is something he desperately wants, but he's not going to achieve it now behind anything crazy going on these final 10 laps. And he's come out him in pair actually, so
car seems to be struggling a lot on those back tires.
Yeah, so, well, Pair obviously pitting early for them full wets and enemy, you know, burned up a little bit. Michael caught some fresh wets, which does make a big difference around any track. So he's going to be quicker, definitely.
Them fresh wets does make a difference.
Does. I can't do English sometimes. His conditions are poor. Like, it's still raining hard and it's full wet as it is, so following another drive around here is going to be tough. Michael's going to have that problem.
Well, very, very apart from the top thing, I believe, is, you know, struggling for grip.
But Michael, that is fantastic. Corner cover, I've ever seen it. As we mentioned his corner cutting whenever I'm on him. I'm not even doing it for corner cutting, I was just on him to see how he is behind Pear, but Pear, well, he has had the fastest lap of the race, who knows, been struggling now. Well, I do believe that will stay towards the end of the race. I don't believe anyone who's gonna go faster than a 42.9. I'm gonna be suspicious.
That'll be corner cutting.
Yes.
Did Mayer, did Michael's DRS pop up there?
Didn't see what it there. No, it doesn't look very strange as we're from an angle there, but it looks fine now. No way you can have DRS in these conditions. Obviously it's a safety thing not to have it open. In the wet
they can
condition.
Do it, they, I'll say, in the inters they do have it open, but not
in the intermediate conditions you can have it open when it's allowed.
Which you finally can do in F1 2014, 2015.
I remember
you
in
can actually have that.
Obviously in Suzuka last year.
Yeah.
And Hamilton was stuck here on Rosberg. They only allowed it when the conditions were safe on the intermediates because it was bad on the inters at the start. Speaking out bad pairs, line is bad there. Yeah, and they allowed it, and that was Hamilton got past. Very memorable overtake. Michael, is he going to have a move underneath the tunnel? Is he going to be brave? He's going to think much better of it.
He's going
to try and force down to mistake. Some pairs going to have to pit again, because his tyres are not going to be good towards the end of the race. He's struggling as it is.
Yeah.
But he's going to try and brave it out. Look at the plume of spray. How on earth are you ever going to get an overtake done?
If you go on the Mega, he's got a DRS.
Oh shit, I wet
yeah,
my...
but that always happens, he can't open it. Evansy's come online, which is a bit strange. So that's unfortunate, he can race tonight. Another quick driver, which has unfortunately not made it. For whatever reason, would he enjoy these conditions? I'm not even sure. We're enjoying them though, this is quite... it's different.
Pretty interesting. He wouldn't get rain around Singapore.
You're welcome.
This is fantastic though. I had it yesterday.
Changes it up. Gives it a
bit more space.
Oh, Michael's got a much better run. Coming into the old Singapore sling, is he going to try and make a dive bomb? No, again, he thinks better of it. He's definitely got the superior grip. Got a bit more confidence. Is he going to have a go into the airpin? It's going to be alongside. Is he going to do it? He's moved on the inside. He's a bit tentative. Fez can hold it around the outside and get the much better traction. Michael not closing the door as he could have done there, very clean and fair. But it is allowing Pear to keep that fifth place for now.
Pickle's going to have to make a move quick and get a gap if he wants to finish in the top five.
Oh, mistakes like that weren't out though, hitting the wall. Well, they're both. Oh, he's gone straight on! He's locked up, he's gone straight on underneath the tunnel. He's going to have to reverse back on track. That's going to drop him back into last place. Hotshot is going to get past him. Michael, with a chance of victory, is now the last of the runners. And well, he's just not happy with himself. I can tell that.
That was Nico Rosberg on the last time it said Singapore.
Andy Ferrandi in front is lapping consistently a second quicker than Connor Kay, but interestingly Alex Omi is lapping quicker than the pair of them. Always thrives in these conditions, does Alex, and he's not far off Connor Kay considering the pace he has and the amount of laps to go. He could see a battle for second in the next, say, five-ish laps.
Well, this rate. He could be on him at the end of the race. Have a 12-15 second gap.
Andy Ferrandi's in control at the moment. It's going to be a great result for Red Bull for 1-3 on the cards, maybe even a 1-2 if Alex can catch up to Connor Kay, who has drove a very creditable race in second, very quiet race, if anything. Just not being involved in any incidents. Just keeping it out of the wall and keeping it steady, and it seems to be the way to go for him. He's going to be very happy if he can keep that, but Alex Ham again going to be going for it in these conditions.
Because he was, Connor Kay was running very quietly in third when it was dry, but now it's wet, he's running very quietly in second.
Michael messed up.
He lost his front wing again?
No, when he lost his front wing, that's when Connor took second. Yeah. I'd say he was lucky not to lose his front wing again.
Hair ahead of
Mr.
Stephen.
Yeah.
That's
right. Yeah, just noticed that. Just noticed Pear somehow managed to flip him. So like, is a 143 good for F4? I think it will be decently good. I think so lane for F4, 143.
Be careful of Chris around that with this track. His best track, I'd say.
Probably one of my worst tracks.
Probably, I'd say it's one of my better tracks. I do enjoy this track.
It's hard to find a setup sometimes, and then once you do find a good setup, it's not really that good in the race.
Oh, my setup I think is pretty good. It's just not really anything special, it's just I feel comfortable.
Yeah, because, you know, there's drivers in XRL that have completely different driver styles.
Yeah, it just suits my driving style, this track. It's very weird. It was just out of Monaco, but I don't like that track here. It's, you've got a bit more space to work with, and I do enjoy this track. So I think my PB's like a 39.7. It's ridiculous.
And I'm currently trying to arrange to go to Liverpool at this weekend to go go-karting. I currently have all my money on the table, and I've got in this blooming debt.
So you're trying to do mental arithmetic. That
I'm trying to do stuff so I can go kart and everything, like, and watching this race at the same time. So I thank you both for talking and commentating. Actually, really, on both of you, everyone's able to watch. Don't worry, I have seen all the action. I've been on the right people. Alright, I haven't missed it. I'm actually going to jump back to Michael. I'm going to jump back to Michael because he's getting close to Hotshot.
Yeah, I've got on board with him at the moment. But what I mentioned, there could be a battle for second in the cards. It does look to be quite a bit closer between Connor and Alex. Connor's definitely struggling at the moment. I don't know if he's made a few mistakes, but Alex, being the driver he is caught up. He's in the spray now.
I gotta tell you, the Mago coming down into that bridge section under the grandstand, he is breaking very late, which is very gutsy, especially in the wet conditions.
Well, he's not getting his braking spot on at all because there's been instance he's just turned in early and just clipped the inside barrier.
He's braked about there for turn one, which runs him off for turn two.
Max is firmly in.
Oh yeah, that's where my money went.
Michael's right up ahead, Hatchet.
Oh, it turns out that I've given Mom money when I didn't need to because it came out with I'm gonna go nick £8 back off my mum because she's managed to somehow trick me. Because the credit card that's on the Xbox is my one, crying out loud. So 2 minutes.
He let him through.
I had a bit of Connor, he may have just let him through. I'll go back to second now. And you just talk about it.
Battle for second. The rain is not really easing up. Yeah, it's definitely full wet towards the end. No way you're going to see the track drying up. In these last five laps, Sam with, well, it just looks more comfortable in these conditions. There's no word to describe it. Connor K, though, with the trap position, which is definitely vital. If he cannot make any mistakes, even with Alex being the quicker of the two drivers at this moment, he can keep him PI relatively easily. And if Connor can do what he usually does, he's on for a second place finish, which with GP2 will be a fantastic result, but it does run a bit wide. Alex Ham is going to get the traction. He shuts the door, though. That was fantastic defending there by Connor just to get in front of him. He's going to nip the slipstream. Slipstream not really affected. He's going to move to the inside. Connor not giving him much room, but he's giving him enough for a rubble, and he's going to slip down the inside. There's a bit of contact between the two. He's just about got air. Connor's, though, got the inside line for the hairpin. Now he's just going to run wide, and they're going to have similar traction levels. Alex with the inside line for this corner. It's fantastic between these two. Connor's going to run a bit wide, though. That relinquishes Alex into second place, which I would believe he would stay there now, as he has been the quickest of the two drivers. That's fantastic for us to get ahead. That was great battling between the two of them. Unfortunate for Connor, but it's got a massive gap back to fourth, and he'll be happy with a podium finish anyway. So it's going to be a Rebel 1-2 at this current moment, which is fantastic for them and the constructors. Well, and if Randy looks very unopposed for this race win now, these two, well, they've been banned in pair and fourth comfortably, but with an end plate missing, that's not going to help him at all. They have a full front wing. If he's got the pace, he could catch up. Well, there's not really any other battles, as Michael's now pulling away from Hotshot quite considerably in these conditions. A bit erratic as Michael's, the rain has eased up a bit now. So it's basically just a case of can these drivers keep out the wall in these last four laps.
Oh, STB Power is hitting the wall every lap because he seems to be breaking a bit late but turning in early.
Definitely an aggressive.
Let's
have a look at Andy's times in the race director. How's he doing in the full wets at the moment? So, well, now he's dipping under 2 minutes now, so tire wear showing a bit of a factor, but look at laps 24 to 27 for Andy, just have a look, quick, stop what you're doing, have a look at that, have a look at consistency, that's incredible, four laps within what, well, them three laps are in half a tenth of each other, and then, well, he's dropped off a bit on up 27, but, well, tyre wear becoming a bit of a factor now, but it will be a problem towards the end of the race. It will come into effect, but it won't be a problem. but the track will improve as well as the rain has stopped, so that might counteract the times.
Well, loose leg of that and a 1-2 for Ripon. If Alex Hahn can keep it out of the wall.
And if he can keep up the wall as well, but he's been supreme out of Singapore, he's getting pole by. Good. Well, nearly 9 tenths. And well, his pace around there is looked supreme. He's not looked like he's been trying to set from that lag spot, but he's come through the field and well, this is the track where if you make a mistake, you'll get punished and marked for fouls. And well, Andy's locked up a little bit there into the airpin, which I think he's said to do, but he's not lost anything, just probably a few tenths. So, 3 laps to go. Looking good for Red Bull, it's looking good for Ferrari, so with Connor in third. And Connor getting that podium, he'll be happy, and he's got a massive gap to Peru. Well, he's just gonna put this race behind him, I think, and move on to the next one. Ferrari looking to score some points as well. They'll collect 25 points of the troubles if the positions stay as they are.
Remaining of this race, I believe round
14. Everyone remembered.
Well, I couldn't remember.
I can count. Well, we might be about the fifth towards the end of this race. Michael's been around 2 seconds a lap quicker than Mr. Stevo in the last few laps. Obviously, with the fresher 4 works after his incident. In his front wing, maybe coming in good for him now, Mr. Steve, probably struggling a little bit, just trying to keep the consistency and out the wall. But Michael, if he can charge quick enough in these last 2.5 laps, he may have a chance of 5th place, but looking like it'll be on him in the final sector, the final lap, barring anything going on in terms of pace.
Oh, God.
But will Mego be able to catch him, pass him, and
take Steve-O had so much. He was. He nearly spun around the hairpin coming out of it. He couldn't. It just wasn't happening. That rear end on that Ferrari, not liking it.
From what I witnessed in the Ferrari, the back end's obviously, so.
I quite like the Ferrari, though. I mean. I think that's pretty much how I like to drive. I like to drive a bit of understeer, oversteer. Oh my God, Michael, you've hit the wall again. He's not lost any front wing, but...
He's lost a few tenths, but...
And he's losing his dignity as well. I mean, he's probably lost a good second and a half on this lap as he doesn't take the final corner at all.
He's going to have to settle for sick.
Well, the line's becoming very suspect in these final few laps. I've already watched him, so I can't watch him now, but... They're not as clean as you'd like to see an XRL driver do it.
If I get a phone call from some... I get a Skype call from someone. No. No. Not now.
Oh, who'd you get a Skype call from?
Reginald.
Confidential. Who?
Reginald.
Hello, Joe.
We're planning on going go-karting everything, so of course I get a phone call.
Hi, Joe. Yeah, if you're watching.
On the stream, all you can hear is your Skype call going.
You can't now, but you could.
Yeah. Like earlier in the season, there was a Skype call coming through, I think it was Bahrain.
Yeah, there was.
I heard the one from Monza where I called you. How much at that? That's why GP3 last week was a little bit strange because I was just trying to search for a chat cam and she couldn't find one.
Joe. There's lights in Singapore.
Oh my God, there's lights.
Look at the colours.
Yeah, there's a hotel bit there. Look at that. Michael's gone past it. Mm. It changes colours and stuff. Oh, I'll come back onto it. Oh, Michael, look at that.
Just stay there.
Oh my god!
Oh my god, it's turning blue.
Oh no, no, not the song. Not the song again.
No.
The colour song, we made a colour song.
Oh yeah. But that can only be sung at Abu Dhabi because there's plenty of colours there.
Oh yeah, Abu Dhabi's gonna be fun on the last race of the season, we're gonna enjoy that. Hopefully Paul can be with me for that, and you can hear us too. We could have had it last season with GP3, but Adam has really bad connection and couldn't stream it.
Yeah, he basically had the same smoke signal as the Tamo to message me, and you know.
Yeah. Well, I didn't mention Michael could catch up to Mr. Stevo in the final few laps, such as his pace on these tyres, and well, he's in the spray now, so it's definitely something to watch on this final lap. Seven Boredom in the final set to the final lap. He's already catching up through his middle sector.
Oh, there's the hotel.
Oh, he's in the wall.
Oh, he's in the wall though again. Oh, making these little mistakes. It's just costing him time. Time's lost about probably another half a second there. Well, it was strange to think he was in the lead and was in quite good control. Because of his mistakes, it has allowed Andy Ferrandi to come back through the field, and such as his pace, going to take this room very comfortably. A very good result for him as he crosses the line. Very well done to him, and that exam is going to complete the 1-2 for Rebel.
There's
maximum
the
points. Definitely maximum points. Rebel and for that exam, another great result in changeable conditions. He always loves them. Well, he dropped Connor K quite a bit, but he's going to come around the final call to score a podium in GP2.
But what is going to happen for 5th place is Megal is right up behind Mr. Stevo.
An awful, awful race is going to come 4th. He's got to be happy with that.
Oh, this is going to be a battle to the end. Battle to the end. Oh, Stevo's lost.
Out of traction.
Try and launch it down the inside. He's going to defend his inside.
Outside.
No, he's not getting traction. Is he on out? Oh, he's going to be on the outside. Michael, is he going to get a place? Yes, he is.
Yeah, he got it.
Mr. Stevo's run out of fuel.
That better not
like.
Beat me and Mali's gap at fucking Malaysia, because that was just a better finish.
Well, I was just going to round out the finishes in 7th, just not having the best of races, it's hot shot, so he's going to reverse over the finish line. Don't blame him, there's only a 10th between them two in the end. But, well, Michael's salvaging 5th place after a load of mistakes, so only for Andy getting a comfortable win in the end from his teammate, it would have fought Alex Ham again, demonstrating why. In these conditions, I had him down for 3rd and he got 2nd, so...
I believe me and Molly still hold hard to the finishers.
I think I got the closest podium of anybody.
But you didn't get the tightest finish because me and Molly were just unbelievable at Malaysia.
It's not as close as Bahrain F4 seasons.
Or F1.
You are a god.
I know I am. Great, aren't I?
Your podium predictions are, damn.
Well, no, I had John Digweed to finish 2nd, and unfortunately, he was on the drive.
Well, I got one of mine, Patrick.
I got one of mine.
I got Conor Kay
third.
I got Andy first.
Andy first. Didn't work, actually. Let's move over to anyway, Andy, of course. Very dominant win in the end. Obviously, a lag spike at the beginning, costing your track position, which could have cost you the race win, but in these changeable conditions, you kept your head cool and you drove a very clean race. So, well done for you. How was it out there?
So, really just starting the race, the lag spike was great, and that put me down to 3rd, so I had a bit of catching up to do. But I did manage to pass Sam. And until then, Michael went for an early pit stop, and I pitted a bit later, and then I was starting to catch Michael through the dry conditions, and I managed to pass him just before all the rain came, and just managed to keep it on the track. Michael crashed a few times, and that put him out of the top 3, and just managed to cruise to the 9.
Well, yeah, you obviously kept your ankle in them full wet conditions. We see a lot of drivers struggle, but you seem to have really good pace around here. Do you think it's just a Red Bull thing where everyone was comfortable on the full wets?
I don't know. Alex is the wet weather strategist.
You know it.
I wasn't expecting that quite that pace in the wet, but qualifying pace was just, I don't know, it was just hadn't even done that lap before.
Well, you pulled that out when it mattered, so well done for you for another race win, another 25 points. Thank you. Coming over to you, you've done it again in these changeable conditions. You just love it, and there's nothing really else to say. You know, obviously in the dry, you're just not really having the pace, the challenge at the front, but when it comes, when the rain comes, you seem to be at your best, so very well done for you. How was it?
It was good. I was surprised I actually wasn't in last place after qualifying, but I got a bit of a rough start getting sandwiched between John and Pear, but obviously no one got any damage or anything. I was a bit of touchy-feely-feely, and then through the whole of the dry stint, I had a really good battle with Pear and Hotshot. Obviously, they pitted two laps earlier, so they made a massive undercut, but I was able to close in the gap because they kept battling, and then made a pretty, in my opinion, good overtake on Pear just before the rain came down. No, I think it was just after the rain came down, because me and Connor both pitted a lap too late for the intermediates, and I was really surprised by the pace I had in the full wets, because I was catching Connor by about a second and a half a lap, and when I got past him, I was catching Andy by about 8/10 a lap. So probably one of the fastest cars on track in the wet.
Well, that's definitely what I think got you that second place with full wet conditions, and you've done it, so Matt, some points to Red Bull, well done for you for second. Connor, driving a very quiet race, it must be said, into third, but obviously not really being in any battles, just quietly going about your business, letting other drivers make the mistakes. Obviously, you had that battle with Alex, which, well, you unfortunately lost second place, but how happy are you with third, obviously reserving for GP2?
Yeah, definitely happy. I mean, I thought I had okay pace in the dry. As soon as I went to wet tyres, well, I had not practiced, but I didn't realise how slow it was. Probably was one of the slowest on the track. So, glad that I managed to hold on to a podium, and yeah, hopefully the same next time.
Yeah, well, you do have F4 later this week, so are you feeling confident ahead of that race that you can have another go at another race win?
As long as it's not wet, yes.
Yeah. Well, there is normally quite a high chance around here, so but you're going to be open its dry anyway, so you can actually see Connor on, I believe it'll be Wednesday for F4, GP3 will be tomorrow, and that will be with me, and whereas obviously F4 will be with whoever can be bothered to show up, and F5000 will be with BHA bottling waiter, and whereas obviously his race didn't, but as planned. And next week will be, what track is it? Japan.
Japan? What the hell?
Japan. No, that's already Japan.
You don't know the calendar. Come on, Joe.
No, what the hell?
I get confused around this time of year. Don't matter. We'll gloss over that. So Japan's next week. We've got that to look forward to. But anyway, after an exciting race, you got this week's action at Singapore to look forward to. From me, from Wes, from Paul, from everyone on the podium, to everybody at home, good night to everybody.
Strawberry milkshake.
Yay!